Hey, what's up? Today I'm gonna do, tonight rather, do this video on the best type of fast. First, I wanna say Happy New Year. A lot has happened. We are in our new spot, and I wanna thank everybody for supporting us over the years as we transition, but like I said, I wanted to talk about the different types of fasts. I know a lot of people are interested in fasting this time of the year. You may be having your New Year's resolutions. And this is something I've been thinking about for the last few months. So I said, you know, tonight I'm not going to delay any further. We're going to do this video. I'm going to share with you from my experience, you know, working with like literally thousands of people over the last, I guess, 10 or so years. Myself, you know, doing juice fasting, doing water fast, dry fast. So what is the best? Let's get right into it. What is the best type of fast? Well, really, I don't want to say what is the best, but I just wanted to kind of discuss each one and some of the pros and cons of each one. So let's get into it. So we have dry fasting, which is just being on the breath. That is the true essence of fasting. When we look at it historically, we look at it in spiritual traditions. And then we have water fasting. You know, and obviously there's like different kinds of water, spring water, distilled water, even tap water, and then you have juice fasting. You know, so, you know, I've seen people do different types of fasts. You know, a lot of people, you know, talk about, well, there's a number of people talking about fasting on YouTube and intermittent fasting and, you know, what that is. But I'm going to really stick to it, like, in terms of, like, you know, if you're doing your fast, what type of fast you should consider. Well, let's talk about dry fasting. Dry fasting, as I mentioned, is really the true essence of a fast. That's basically nothing passing by your lips instead of air. You know, you're just on the breath. And, you know, within a 24-hour cycle, as we go to sleep, this is what we are practicing. We're practicing dry fasting when we rest, essentially. And the main pro with this type of fast is, especially if you go beyond a 24-hour cycle into a 36-hour cycle when you go to sleep twice. So let's say, like, right now it's going on 12 o'clock. I would start my dry fast before I go to sleep. Like, or I would start it now. Go to sleep, wake up the next day, which will be Tuesday. Don't eat or drink nothing for the whole day Tuesday. Go to sleep tomorrow night, and then when I wake up, I may have some water. So when I'm speaking of fasting, I'm speaking on at least a 36-hour time frame for any fast. This intermittent and this other stuff about fasting for 8 hours or 16 hours or, you know, to me, it's really, especially when we speak in terms of healing, because the real healing happens while we're sleeping. So for any of these types of fasts, I'm talking a minimum 36 hours. Okay, you have to go to sleep twice. So the main pro with a dry fast is, like, you're going to experience healing on the highest level. The fact that your body is not going to have to deal with any water, any food of any kind for at least that 36-hour period, your body can now turn its full attention to healing. And so the thing is, it's like, because it's so aggressive, that's really the main con. The main con is that it could be too aggressive, and most people are not there. And it's like, it's something that even myself personally, I have really minimal experience with it. Again, you can get pretty much all of the benefit of fasting with either using water or juice. But if you want to really take it to the highest level, and then I think the main reason you would do dry fasting is not for healing necessarily. It's maybe more for just to gain some sort of spiritual awareness, clarity, etc. You're doing it for other reasons other than for health reasons. So that would be like the reason that you would consider doing a dry fast. Now, water fast, what is the main pro? And when we talk about water fasting, I should mention there is a big difference between doing distilled water versus spring water. But the main pro for doing water fasting is, again, very similar to doing dry fasting. You're going to get healing at a very fast rate because you're not bringing in any nutrition. You're not bringing in any vitamins, minerals, anything that the body has to work or process. So again, it could pretty much turn its full attention to healing. When, you know, the thing is, like, people ask me all the time, oh, what's good for this and what's good for that and what juice is good for this? And it's really, they need to be asking the opposite question. It's like, what do you need to stop eating? You know, what do you need? You know, when we look at health, you know, the body is designed to heal itself. And, you know, we really have to get into the mindset of thinking, like, not what else I can put into my body to make it heal. It's what I need to stop, what I need to start eliminating, you know, and to start fasting. You know, fasting is the ultimate healer for the body. It is the, you know, and it just makes so much perfect sense because, again, it's all, for number one, it's all plumbing. It's all work that the body has to do, you know, in terms of, you know, putting food in. So it's like, it's always a give and take. So because the body has to not only process, but when you think about everything that you eat, the body is designed to hold some for a rainy day, hold some for a day where it may not be any food around. You know, if we were reliant on nature and we had to forage or find our own food, there may be a day or two or three where you may not find anything. So the body, therefore, has a sort of a safety method in terms of like what you last ate, it still holds a little bit of that. So then, you know, that becomes your alternative fuel. It's like your backup fuel source. And because we eat all the time and we have everything almost available all the time, 24/7, even right now you could order food from your phone, you can order food on a computer, they make it so convenient. We never give our bodies opportunity to heal via fasting. So we have to voluntarily, you have to watch videos like this. You have to go and do research and get inspired. I'm trying to inspire you to use this ancient form of medicine to be your best self for 2019, you know. So the thing is like, you know, doing dry fasting, water fasting, you're really tuning in a very fast way, you know. So again, the main pros, just to recap, is that you're gonna heal quickly because the body is now gonna use those alternative fuel, which ironically enough, we look at as toxins. You know, that becomes a buildup. You'll notice as, especially, and again, I was talking today, somebody asked me, oh, should I do a 3-day fast or should I do a 5-day fast? Well, really, the answer is really simple because, I mean, 3 days, even 3 days is better than no days. But if you want to do longer than 3 days, that's when you really start to get the real benefit after the third day. Why is that? Because it takes 2 to 3 days for your intestines to empty. After your intestines empty, then your body starts to really tap into that alternative fuel, a la toxins, a la mucus, that's stored everywhere in your body. Everywhere that your blood travels, mucus will be. Everywhere that is, then your body will tap into that for fuel. You'll start to feel better. You'll get a boost in energy. You'll lose weight, of course. And you, most importantly, heal. You'll maintain the body. Let's talk about juice fasting. Now, with juice fasting, the main pro, and this is what I want to get into, because, you know, with water fasting and dry fasting, you're gonna heal whatever your goal is, you're going to be able to, you know, get that. But with juice fasting, the main difference is, like, you're going to be able to, one, experience those same benefits. Not as fast, but in exchange, you'll be able to, because the thing is like, you know, one question that I always get over the years is like, wow, I feel so amazing, you know, doing this fast, especially when they do like 7, 10, 14 days, you know, they're like, wow, you know, and then, you know, coming off that, you're like concerned about your eating. And that is one of the main reasons why you would do a juice fast over a water or a dry fast. Because doing juice fasting, you're now basically using, you know, the juices are going to be fruits and vegetables. And those are going to be the things that you're going to want to primarily eat. So that's the main advantage of a juice fast, is now you're basically you're relying on the fuel of the essence of the fruit and vegetable, which is the juice, as your primary fuel source. Now, because you're getting calories, you're getting nutrients, you're getting vitamins and minerals, it will also give you enough energy to be able to do everything you got to do, whether it's go to work out within reason, but you'll be able to pretty much exist. On a water fast or a dry fast, you may or may not be able to do those things. You know, it just depends on where your body is, and it depends on the person. It depends on, there's a lot of different factors. You may have the energy, you may not, on just water. But with juice, you can enjoy, you know, because the other thing we got to think about too is, especially with fruits, there are probably tens of thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of fruits. Obviously, we probably have exposure to maybe not even 1,000, let's say a couple of hundred. But then, you know, there are hundreds of varieties of those, at least hundreds of fruits. And let's be honest, most of us don't eat fruit. And most of us don't ever eat, obviously, the varieties of these hundreds of fruits and vegetables. And again, we're not even talking about vegetables. We're just talking about fruits. And the thing is like, you know, fruits are so close to water, at least a lot of fruits. And, you know, and because they're so close to water, they become very healing just by indulging in just fruits. And with that said, you know, if we fast, there's really it really almost presents a bridge where we don't have to go so extreme to water. We can really stay at fruits and enjoy all these different types of, I mean, this incredible food group that we never really, you know, as a society, as a people, never really get into. So that's another big pro in my view. Like, we never really allow ourselves to indulge in this type. Like, I mean, who eats, like, just a fruit? Maybe some people may do a fruit salad for dinner, but, you know, I mean, who does that? Maybe we'll eat, like, a banana or something in the morning with whatever else you're eating, or you'll have a fruit as a snack, or you'll do, but, like, who's making, like, fruit for meal, and especially... You know, I mean, again, it's just such a, just thinking about the amount of fruits and the juices that it can produce, so we never really get into it, at least in terms of what's available and what's offered, you know, so I think that also is a incredible reason to, you know, stay with or consider doing juices versus like just water or doing a dry fast. You know, another thing I think is a tremendous pro is like if you want to consider doing an extended fast because, you know, just for the reason I said earlier, you know, in terms of being able to change your taste buds, like because that's ultimately what you would want to do. I mean, you're going to eat more than you not eat. If we looked at each day of this upcoming year, you're probably going to, with the maybe 360 days or so that's left for 2019, you're going to probably eat at least 300 of those days. Let's be real with that, all right? And so because you're going to eat more days than you're not going to eat, you're going to want to, you're going to want to eat the best foods. Most people, and it's just crazy to think about because most people are going to not only eat every day, but you're going to eat probably a starch and a protein, whether you're vegan or you're non-vegan. Let me clarify that. You're going to eat a cooked starch and a cooked protein. Why is that important to mention that? Well, it's important to mention because if you're eating a cooked protein, you're eating something that your body is going to have a very difficult time to process, very difficult time to digest, especially when you combine it with that starch. You know, if you eat a sandwich, you eat, let's say, breakfast, you know, tomorrow morning, are you going to have your waffle, you're going to have your bagel, you're going to have your, whatever it is, or oatmeal. So if you have that's your protein, again, a heavy protein and a heavy starch, always. And it's so addictive. And what ends up happening is like, it ends up not really breaking down in the body. And it forms a lot of mucus. And that mucus builds up. And then in specific times of the year, when that mucus builds up and then it starts to want to release itself, then you start to blame it on germs. You know, so that's the problem. Instead of, you know, really bringing in high-level moisture, you know, fruits, fresh juices, green juices, our healthy nut milks, because, you know, we need healthy oils, healthy fats. And to bring these all in a liquid form, especially if we're doing it in an extended way, maybe 7 days, 14 days, etc. Now we allow the body to bring in a level of living nutrition in a liquid form that your body is going to now use And you're also going to allow your body to also feed on the residue, on the backup fuel source. Because every time you eat, you're getting your body is saving some for a rainy day. So, you know, there's a lot of pros to juice fasting. Obviously, you know, I may be biased because that's what, you know, we that's what, you know, that's a big part of my business. So, but you know, I talk about this in my book, and you know, and this is something that I live. The last thing I want to say, you know, is like, you know, as I wrap this up, really, you know, I really want to get into the coconut water because, you know, a lot of people talk about water. You know, I was just watching a video on YouTube, you know, our king ancestor Dick Gregory is talking about spring water and talking about fasting and, you know, one of my heroes. You know, but one of the things like that we know today, especially when we talk about coconut water, is that in my mind, not even, I mean, it's just a fact that it is definitely the best water. And if you want to do the ideal fast, do 100% coconut water. Like, no other juice, no green juice, no fruit juices, do 100% coconut water. Like, if you can find living fresh coconut water and fast on that and extend it, basically, you're gonna get everything you need. You're gonna get everything you need. One thing about coconut water, it is the only food that is both water and food. Like, water is not food. Like, spring water, distilled water definitely is not food. Alkaline water, you know, people with these machines trying to mimic what nature naturally produces, definitely not like a whole food, you know. And then of course our fresh juices, those are not whole foods, you know. We're processing, we're removing the juice from the fiber, and we get benefit, but it doesn't match coconut water. Coconut water is, you know, you're drinking it as nature intended for you to drink it, and it's perfect water for the human body. And fasting on it is really the ideal because you'll get everything you need in terms of, you know, I mean, you're gonna get hydrated, of course. You're gonna get vitamins, minerals, etc. in a perfect form. But then you're also gonna be able to heal, and the body is gonna be able to rebalance itself, correct itself, all of the damage and all of the improper foods you've been eating. It's gonna feed on those things. It's gonna use them as fuel, and it's gonna correct itself. So coconut water, definitely, in my experience, you know, my humble professional opinion, definitely the best. Again, a living, it's naturally distilled water. You know, it's important that we drink actually distilled water versus spring water or mineral or even alkaline water, because distilled water is a water that will detox you, and it will pull from you what you don't need, you know. So coconut water be living, distilled and mineralized, loaded with potassium. And what is potassium good for? It's good for your heart. What's the number one killer? Heart disease. Why is that? Because our hearts are working too hard. We're putting, again, this is all plumbing right here. And the body has, you know, that pump, that heart is a pump, is having to overwork itself. Because again, the whole system is clogged up. You know, we eat too much, we drink too much. You don't hear that very often. Yeah, you're drinking too much. You're drinking too much. You're eating too much. You don't give the body a break. It overworks the heart. And then to add to that, you know, life stressors, etc., etc. it's just one bad thing after another. And then when, you know, stresses happen in life, you know, food becomes a crux. So it's just, you know, bad on top of bad. But coconut water, definitely, in my humble professional opinion, the best out of the, if we had to say dry fast, water fast, meaning water like either, you know, not including coconut water, like spring water, distilled water, tap water, juice, or let's say juice and smoothies, okay, because I know some people like to do that, juice, smoothies, and soups. Again, fantastic. If you did a juice, smoothie, and soup fast, you will detox. Again, not as fast, but it will. It's more of a gentle, because your body's getting like nutrition. But coconut water will be definitely even over dry fasting, in my opinion, because, you know, I think that you know, over water and dry, you know, I mean, coconut water, it just tastes so good, and this process should be enjoyable. You should want to fast. You know, that's one of the things, like, I think, you know, as health seekers, but just as living beings, you know, healing shouldn't be painful. You know, unfortunately, you know, especially in this type of work that I do, when I encounter people who want to be healthy, it usually comes after a health scare, you know, meaning that they have some sort of issue that could usually be life-threatening, you know, whether it's in the short term, immediate, or even long term being like a year or 5 years or etc. So, you know, don't wait till then. You know, to be healthy is a wonderful thing. You know, something that it should be somewhere on your priority list for this upcoming year. You know, I hope that you would, you know, take that initiative. And my hope is that I've inspired you to consider that, you know, because, you know, for us to be healthy, you know, as individuals, we become healthy, you know, our families become healthier, you know, and then our communities become healthier, you know, so, and it makes a better place, a better world to live in. So, thanks for tuning in. I will sign off now. Yeah, I'll be posting this on YouTube. You know, it's not too late. If you want to come on the retreat, you know, I'm be going to Jamaica in a few weeks. I believe it's the February 6th through the 13th. I'll be teaching raw foods. We will be we will have a coconut water fasting day. We'll be just drinking coconut straight from the coconut. So hopefully you consider it. What other announcements do I have? That might be it. So, again, thanks for tuning in. I want to thank everyone. I've seen a couple people. I didn't get a chance to give anybody a shout out, but I will be posting this video on YouTube. You can comment, ask questions. So thank you again, and I wish you the best year. I wish that all of your hopes and goals for this year come true. So if you're a better version of you, then you can make that happen. So with that, I sign off. Peace.